Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new, welcome. My name is Jessica, also known as Chic Professor on Instagram, and I make videos on luxury goods, the pre-loved market, sustainable fashion, and workwear. Today's video is a collaboration with Brandy from I Am Lady Lux, and I am super excited about this video. I love Brandy. She is a classy, smart, intelligent woman, and her luxury collection is to die for. It is spectacular. You have to go and watch her if you have not already. She has pieces I've just never seen anyone else have, and her collection is enormous and beautiful. So you definitely should go and check her out. One of the reasons I absolutely adore Brandy is because she is an open, honest, strong woman, and she also has a passion for educating and helping other women, which is something that I adore and something that I try to do as well. Since we both have a love of luxury and workwear, we thought it would be fun to do a collaboration that sort of intersected those two. So what we are doing is a video about ways that you can bring luxury into your professional wardrobe. So kind of subtle, classy ways that you can still have a little bit of luxury, but not be too flashy, not be too in your face. I am lucky enough to work in the academic sphere, so it can be very casual. You kind of have a lot of freeway in terms of the way you choose to present yourself and dress. However, as a young professor, I always try to dress a little bit more professionally, not only to show my students what a big difference it makes. I teach communication, so having that outward appearance look very professional is really important to my image and the way that I get my credibility across to them, but also because it helps me to feel like my best, classiest, smartest self, and so I really enjoy doing that. However, because I do have some flexibility, I definitely interject some edgy fashion vibes in there every once in a while. So if you're not following me on Instagram, I would love to have you join me there. I post my outfits pretty much daily during the work week, so you can kind of see what I get up to. So the way this is going to work is we are going to be talking about 5 different categories each, and we'll have a couple examples for each category for how we personally bring luxury into the workplace. So Brandy is going to be covering some aspects, I'll be covering some aspects, but the 5th category that we each cover is going to be the same. So one of them is going to be kind of what everyone's most excited about on YouTube most of the time, and so we are both going to cover that one. So let's go ahead and get started. The first category that I am going to cover is outerwear, and I personally think that there is no classier, more professional outerwear piece than a trench coat. And if you think about trench coat, I think the first option that comes to mind when you think of luxury trench coats is Burberry, since they are the creator. So I love Burberry trench coats, and I have 4 at this point. I used to have 2 not that long ago, but I have 4 at this point. And so I'm going to show you 3 of them. The one that I'm not going to show you is my sort of nylon packable coat. That one's very casual, so that one would not work well as a professional piece. But here are the other 3. Now, they're not going to come across so well on the screen, but I will link them down below, and then you can also, if you follow me on Instagram, you will see some options there. So the first one is just a plain black trench coat. It's really nothing too exciting. It does have black buttons, though, as well as just a plain black belt. The buttons do say Burberry London, but they're engraved in black, so it is very classy and very subtle. The trench coat is such a beautiful shape, so a black one is a great option for work. Personally, my absolute favorite trench coat is the classic, and I have tried many, and nothing has beaten this vintage one for me. I love this vintage one. It's by far my favorite. I love the length of it. It goes right to the knee. It has a beautiful feminine silhouette. It just has the plain sort of leather buckles. The buttons don't say anything. They're not engraved with Burberry, but I think when you see this on, just because it is the classic color and the classic shape and fabric and everything, you might think it's Burberry, but there certainly isn't anything that screams that out loud. So it's a beautiful piece and something that is so professional, I absolutely adore. Of course, when you take it off, this one does have the Novacek print inside, so it's a little bit more obvious, but while you're wearing it, it is definitely subtle, beautiful luxury. So my last one is a little more out there if you're a little bit more adventurous. It is still the classic trench coat shape, but it is in this black and white pattern. It also has the Burberry written on the buttons, but in a very small font, and it's just kind of the same color as the buttons kind of engraved into it. So that is pretty neutral. What it does have, though, which makes it a little bit fun, I think, is all throughout it has these almost little like graffiti Burberry patterns. It just says Burberry on them, and there's another one back here. They're just kind of all over splattered throughout. They're very subtle and small and hard to see, but it does make it a little bit more fun and fashionable. So if your workplace is a little bit more casual, you might be able to get away with something like this. Next category that I want to cover are belts. I love luxury belts. My favorite by far are the Ferragamo belts. I have three of them, I think, at this point, in both the silver and the gold. And what I like about them is often you get two in one because they're usually reversible. They're very comfortable, and I find that they are a beautiful, subtle luxury. Unlike the GG of the Gucci or the H of the Hermes, they're a little less in your face. They just kind of look like a classic belt buckle, and the Ferragamo is very hard to see. So it's one of those, like, if you know, you know, you might recognize it, but it's not something that is quite as in your face or obviously luxury. And I think they just kind of add a great notch to any outfit. I have had people requesting me to do more videos on this belt, and I do have a video about why I like these more than the Gucci and the Hermes belts, which I'll link down below, but I'm considering maybe doing a video on different ways to style this belt for work. So if you're interested in that, please do let me know. My other luxury belt is this very, very subtle Burberry belt. It's just a small patent belt. It has these double buckles so you can adjust it to be what you want it to be. And the only thing that says Burberry is at the bottom of these buckles. I don't even think it'll show up. And it just says, it doesn't even say Burberry London. It just says Burberry. So it's very, very subtle. I mean, it says it on the inside, but nobody's gonna see that. So it's very subtle. The buckles aren't any particular shape or anything that is recognizable and noticeable, but it is just an easy way to add a little luxury, to feel like you're wearing something really nice, but just looks like a classic professional belt. The next category that I am going to be covering are skirts, and none of my skirts have any kind of insignia on them or logo or anything that makes it obvious that they are luxury clothing pieces. I own a few luxury clothing items. Mostly it's outerwear and shoes. I do a lot of, I wouldn't even call them high street, I would call them like designer brands that I love for workwear, and I don't always think about them as being luxury. I certainly don't own as much ready-to-wear luxury as Brandy does, but you should check out her collection because just stunning and beautiful. But I do have three Chanel skirts I want to show you and one vintage Burberry skirt, so you can see I like my vintage. Actually, a lot of these Chanel skirts are vintage as well. This first one has this really sweet design to it, and it actually is a design that I just saw Natalie from My Daily Sweet pick up in the current Chanel collection, which is great. So they've kind of brought it back. This one is vintage. They're all vintage. Every one of these skirts is vintage, I'm pretty sure. And so I love vintage clothing. This one doesn't have any kind of insignia, but it is sort of this classic shape that Chanel does make quite often with these little pocket designs. So I just love this skirt. I think it is a little bit different than a classic pencil skirt, and I certainly wear plenty of those or classic A-line skirts. It just has the little Chanel inside, but there is nothing that kind of gives it away. The current one does have a small CC, I think maybe like right here or at the bottom, but it is very subtle, and so something like that would be a great addition to your work wardrobe. You can feel really classy, it's beautiful material, but it is very subtle. The next one, again, doesn't have anything special on it, but it is just a classic Chanel tweed. I certainly love Chanel tweed, and I would love to get a blazer. I don't own one yet, but that is definitely on my like lifetime wish list, is to get a beautiful tweed blazer and maybe a full suit. This one is, again, a little vintage tweed skirt, but I always just feel extra special. I have beautiful tweed skirts from other brands like Rebecca Taylor, Nanette Lepore, but there's just something about wearing Chanel that just really makes me kind of lift my head up a little bit higher. It just feels like I'm wearing a piece of fashion history, and I absolutely love that. So this one is another really classic, easy way. You're wearing the tweed, which is certainly a nod to Chanel no matter where you get it, but you are doing so actually representing that brand. And my last two are just plain silk pencil skirts. So this one is a vintage Burberry, and this one is a vintage Chanel. Just brown and navy, both classic. They just both have zippers on the back. Nothing that that makes them obvious at all, but they are just beautiful pieces that are both vintage. They've lasted the test of time because they're such high quality materials, and I found them for great prices because they are vintage. So these are great pieces to add into your wardrobe, but nothing really particularly special about them that makes them luxury. They're just kind of high quality pieces. So now to move on to my favorite category, which is shoes. I am such a shoe lover. I absolutely adore shoes. My favorite shoes are these Prada pointy toe pumps. I adore these. I think that they are beautiful, and I think they are the perfect subtle professional shoe. So this shoe, I'll sort of show you the bottom. The bottom is kind of dirty, but the shoe is just a plain pointed toe leather. I think pointed toe adds a little sophistication, makes them look a little bit more professional a lot of times than a rounded toe. Even though I do love a rounded toe, there's nothing about this that screams Prada except that the cut and the quality of it is beautiful, except for the tiny little Prada emblem on the back. It's not something that's very obvious, but it is a nice little tiny subtle hint of luxury that I think is absolutely appropriate for the workplace. You can see I've kind of nicked these heels. My red ones have, again, the same emblem on the bottom. They're a little bit more bright and in your face, but I think that they're a beautiful red, and I think they're totally a professional color. So if you're ready to be a little bit more adventurous, then you can get them in a color as well. I would say that even though it does have a small emblem on the bottom, it is a little bit better than a Louboutin, a little bit more less obviously luxury. Speaking of, if you are going to do a Louboutin, my absolute favorite are the simple pumps. Not only do I find them the most comfortable, but I also find them the most classy and professional for work. Of course, I've had the rubber bottoms put on, but of course, this red sole, when someone sees that, it is pretty obvious. I think most people do know about Louboutins and the red sole, but I don't necessarily think that that's not professional. It depends on your environment. I think that if you watch any TV shows that have like high performing professional women, a lot of times they are in Louboutins. It's not like you're wearing ones with spikes. It's not like you're wearing the Valentino Roxas that are a little bit more adventurous, let's say, a little bit less subtle. I think something like this is fine, and especially because it comes, I mean, this is a 100 millimeter height, so it's a 4-inch heel, which is really the tallest that I wear. I generally prefer a 3.5-inch heel, but because they're not these 5-inch pointed toe, really kind of sexy heels, I think that they are appropriate for work as long as you feel like the red is something that works in your office environment. And the last shoes I want to mention are, again, Ferragamo, just like the belt. I think it's, again, if you know, you know. And these both have the Vera bow. So these are just some pointed toe pumps, and I have these in multiple colors. They've been worn quite a bit. They're a bit faded. And then these are the classic Vera pump. I really think of these as a flat. Now, this one has the leather bow as opposed to the fabric bow. So they are a smarter buy. They just will last longer than the fabric bow will. And they do say Ferragamo on them, but I think the bow is classy. Personally, I don't think it's too in your face. I think it adds a nice feminine touch to these shoes, and that they are appropriate for work. Certainly the heel height for both of these are appropriate, and I personally prefer a patent shoe most of the time just because I feel like it lasts a lot longer, and it always just kind of looks shiny and professional. So I think that Ferragamo is a great way to go, but it is going to be something a little bit more obvious than, let's say, the Prada pointed toe pumps. And now for the final category, which is going to be the one that Brandy and I are both covering, and that is going to be your work bags, your work totes. I have a whole video on my favorite work totes, which is pretty much all of my totes because I love them, but there are some that are definitely more subtly luxurious than others. So some quick ones that I would not suggest for a professional environment where you don't feel comfortable showing off the luxury are these two. So not only are they kind of floppy totes, and so they don't have the structure that you would expect in a professional bag, but even though this is a Damier Ben, and I definitely prefer this to the monogram Louis Vuitton, and I think it is less obvious, it is still so saturated in the market that I think it's pretty recognizable. So I really only wear this on a casual day. I don't wear it very often to work. This one, I think this is the Dior Panerea tote. I think this is less obvious and more professional just because I think the quilting is a really beautiful touch, but the big Dior charm, I think, is what makes this one problematic. You could put it on this side, and I think that then it would be fine. You can certainly wear it backwards. This is coated canvas, so it's not going to be as luxurious as a leather, but still, this is a tote that is going to be sort of floppy. It has more structure than the Neverfull, and it does snap closed, but I'd say this one kind of teeters on the edge of being super professional or not. The three that I am going to show you are this one, which is one of my favorites, which is the Prada Luxe Tote. Certainly the Prada emblem is there. You can see it, but it isn't all over the bag. It isn't super branded. You have to look kind of closely. I would say, again, if you watch movies and TV shows, most of the time, professional women, this is sort of the bag they carry. I think that that's Prada's customer and one of the reasons I love them. But it is a really easy one to just turn around. And then it is just a plain leather tote. A beautiful leather tote, but just a plain tote. And I think the Saffiano is classy and beautiful. So personally, I love this one, but I know that that's not everybody's cup of tea, but it is really easy to just quickly turn around or turn towards the front and have just a subtle little bit of luxury. Another tote that I don't think is too branded that works really nicely as a subtle luxury piece is going to be the Mulberry Bayswater. This is the Heritage Bayswater, and the newer versions are a little bit more young and fresh and fashionable and maybe less appropriate for work. The Bayswater lends itself towards looking like a briefcase and also is similar looking to the Birkin. You can wear the flap inside like you can with the Birkin as well, but it is not a Birkin, and so it is a little bit less obvious, I would say, for work and a little bit more professional. I think the Birkin can be professional, but I think it also just carries this status about it that when people see it, they may not think professional right away. It certainly does have the postman's lock, which can be fairly obvious, but Mulberry isn't something here. In the UK, totally different story, but here I don't think it's very well known. So when people see that, they don't necessarily jump to, oh, that's a luxury bag. I don't think that that's the way that people see it. And I just, this bag is so hearty and beautiful, and I really do love it. This is in the oxblood color, but there are so many other colors you could choose from. I think it's a great option. And the last bag I'm going to carry is my favorite bag. It is the bag that gets the most wear in my collection, and that is the Louis Vuitton Brea bag. I think that the epi leather, unlike the canvases, is much more subtle and much more professional. I love the shape of this bag. I think it looks like a briefcase, but a very chic briefcase. The epi is not super recognizable, and the small Louis Vuitton hardware, although the hardware is certainly there, it is very hard to see. You have to get really up close to it to actually see what it says. And then this is the back, so there's nothing else on it. And then if you look at the front of this bag, it has the small LV embossed in the corner, but it is very, very subtle, and so I think it's totally appropriate for work. This strap makes it a little bit more casual, but when you take that off, it definitely just appears like a beautiful briefcase. So those are the categories that I am covering for this video. Make sure that you check out Brandy's video, which I will link here as well as down below, so that you can see the other categories she covers and which bags she is going to be sharing as well. Please let me know your favorites and what you like to bring into the workplace, how you incorporate a little bit of luxury into your everyday fashion. I would absolutely love to know. If you haven't subscribed, but you are interested in my content, I would love to have you here, and I hope that you have a wonderful day, and I will see you in another video. Bye.